Right, crystal lattice, space lattice, and unit cell. So, what is crystal lattice, and what is space lattice, and next is what is unit cell. Right, the simple definition of crystal lattice is a set of points, which indicates the three-dimensional arrangement of particles, or else you can take it may be atoms or ions, even molecule, is called crystal lattice or space lattice. Listen first, I'll give the notes clearly. First, try to understand what is the definition. Right, there are some set of points which indicates the three-dimensional arrangement of particles. So particles nothing but either you can take atoms, ions, or molecule. So which is called crystal lattice or space lattice. For example, let us take this is one cube. Okay. So here is a back and one more. Okay, if I write all the corners particles, right? Is back side, this is front side. Now see, you just imagine there are some particles. Okay, right, so these are set of points. These set of points now which indicates what? Three-dimensional arrangement of what? They indicate the three-dimensional arrangement of the what? Particles, or three-dimensional arrangement of nothing but atoms. So therefore, this kind of 3D arrangement of particle, the 3D arrangement of this kind of particle is nothing but what? Crystal lattice or space lattice. Now this is a crystal lattice, right? Or else in simple word, what is a crystal lattice? Crystal lattice, space lattice, nothing but it is a three-dimensional arrangement of particle. Okay, nothing but the arrangement of a particle in the space. So how particles are arranged in space, that is nothing but crystal lattice. So here, now how they are arranged in the form of cube, no? It is showing cube. Therefore, these particles are arranged in 3D space, so they are giving cube. This is also one space lattice or crystal lattice. So therefore, crystal lattice, space lattice, nothing but it is a three-dimensional arrangement of particles in the space. 3D in space only, called what? Crystal lattice or space lattice. Then in crystal lattice, space lattice, now this each point is called what? Lattice point. Okay, here each point is called lattice point. This lattice point is nothing but it may be atom, it may be ion, it may be molecule. So this lattice point may be ion in case of ionic solid, right? This lattice point may be molecule in case of molecular solid. It may be atom in case of covalent solid. It may be metal atom in case of metallic solid. Therefore, it is a lattice point. Okay, then when these lattice points are joined, see, this is one lattice point, this is one lattice point. When all these lattice points are joined in a straight line, which gives the geometry of the crystal. Okay, you just imagine there was no lines, it is only points are there. Now later we can join. Okay, right, like this, all these are points are there, lattice points are there. When this all the lattice points are joined in a straight line, what it gives? Nothing but we have joined, no? All the lattice points we have joined in a way, how? Straight line. By joining all the lattice points in a straight line, which gives what? Geometry. That is geometry of the crystal. Okay, so these two points important in lattice point or crystal lattice. What is the first point? What is lattice point? What is the Crystal lattice. Crystal lattice is nothing but three-dimensional arrangement of particles. That's it. 3D arrangement of particle. How particles are arranged in 3D space? That is a crystal lattice. Next, in crystal lattice, each point indicate lattice point. That lattice point may be atom, ion or molecule. Third point, when all these lattice points are joined in a straight line, which gives a geometry of the crystal. For example, you take this only. I have joined all the lattice point in a straight line. It gives cube. This is nothing but cube or not? Therefore, here given the cube. Next is unit cell. So what is unit cell and types of unit cell? Tell me, what is a unit cell? Unit cell is, it is the smallest repeating unit of a big crystal. For example, you just imagine there is a big crystal. A big crystal is made up of many small units, right? This is one small unit. Another small unit, you can go on, write, draw many small units. This is another small unit. Okay, there are many small units, right? Now let us say it is one crystal. In this crystal, if you go on divide crystal, finally what do you get? You'll get a smallest part or not? You divide maartha hodre, finally you'll get a small portion, right? That small portion is nothing but what? Unit cell. So therefore, unit cell is nothing but the smallest repeating unit. It should be repeating unit. Because this is one unit cell, another, another, another. If you go on, you know, add many unit cell, you'll get a big crystal. Right? Therefore, what is the unit cell? The smallest repeating unit of a big crystal. It is the smallest repeating unit of a big crystal is called unit cell. Then what is the important of unit cell? So the important of unit cell is, see, the property of any crystal is depends on the property of unit cell. How? Because crystal is made up of unit cell, right? So if you want to know the property of any crystal, we have to study property of what? Unit cell. That's what we need to study about unit cell in detail now. Therefore, the property of any unit cell, any crystal is depends on property of unit cell. Then next we have types of unit cell. Okay, then the arrangement of, based on arrangement of particles, unit cells are classified into two types. One, primitive or simple unit cell. Second one is centered unit cell. One is a primitive, which is also called simple. Second one is centered unit cell. Okay, right? Next, centered unit cell further classified into three types. Body centered, face centered, end centered. Very good. Okay, right till here. Right on. Crystal lattice or our space lattice. So yesterday's class, how many page? Yesterday's class, yes page again? Three? So leave three pages. Today's students, leave three pages and write. Okay. Right on. Crystal lattice or our space lattice. Right on. A set of points which indicates the a set of points which indicates the three dimensional arrangement of particles over our atoms or ions or molecule called crystal lattice over our space lattice called crystal lattice or space lattice. Next slide. Okay. Next slide. Right. In crystal lattice, each point indicates lattice point or lattice site. In crystal lattice, each point indicate lattice point or lattice site. Next point. When these lattice points are joined in a straight line, to form geometry of crystal. Okay. So take this diagram. First, draw the cube. Okay, next unit cell. See this confusing. First, draw the cube. Okay, cube draw madi. Then, ilodi. Okay, then one more. Next, another back. That's it. Then at all the corners, draw one particle. Okay, next unit cell. Unit cell. A smallest repeating unit of a big crystal is called unit cell. Next, the property of crystal is depends on The property of crystal is depends on property of unit cell. Classification of unit cell based on arrangement of particle. Based on arrangement of particles. Okay, right. Listen. So based on arrangement of particles, unit cells are basically classified into how many types? Two types. One, simple or which is also called primitive, right? Simple or primitive unit cell. Second one is centered unit cell. There are two types of unit cell. Tell me, what is simple or primitive unit cell? Simple unit cell is the unit cell in which particles are present only at corners, right? If the particle present only at corners is a simple or primitive unit cell. What is a center unit cell? The unit cell in which particles are present at corners as well as other than corners. So what are the other than corners? Other than corner may be, it may be face, it may be edge, it may be center, it may be, yeah, that's it, face, edge, center, etc. Then that is called centered unit cell. Okay, let's see. First one, write down, simple or primitive unit cell. The unit cell in which particles are present only at corners called the unit cell in which particles are present only at corners called simple or primitive unit cell. Example, simple cubic crystal. And tell me, it is a cubic. So it means we need to draw the cube. Right? This is a cube. Now tell me, where the particles are present? Only corners. There are how many corners? 8 now. Cube has 8 corners. Okay. So this is a simple cubic crystal. In simple primitive unit cell, particles are present only at corners. Next, second one is body centered unit cell. Okay, let's see first centered. Okay, centered unit cell. Tell me, so what is centered unit cell? The unit cell in which particles are present at corners and other than corner. Corner is compulsory. So along with corner, other than corners. What are other than corners? It may be face, it may be centered, it may be edge. So therefore, the unit cell in which particles are present at corners and other than corners and other than corners, right? So the unit cell in which particles are present at corners and other than corners called centered unit cell. Center unit cell further classified into three types. One, body centered. Body centered unit cell. B, face centered unit cell. C, end centered unit cell. There are three types of centered unit cell. Tell me, first one is body centered unit cell. In body centered unit cell, where the particles are present? Particles are present at corner. Corner is compulsory. Along with corner, there is a one particle also present where? Center of unit cell. So therefore, corners and center of unit cell. So next, what about in face center? Particles are present at corners and along with the center of each face. So therefore, particles are present at corners and center of each face. Next, what about end centered? This is important. Particles are present at corners and any two opposite face, that is called alternate face. Because like, you know, any these two opposite face, these two opposite face is called nothing but alternate face. Right? So therefore, particle present at corners, along with corners, particle also present any two opposite face centered. Okay? Right on. Centered unit cell. The unit cell in which particles are present at corners. The unit cell in which particles are present at corners and other than corners, called centered unit cell. The unit cell in which particles are present at corners and other than corners, called centered unit cell. Next, it is further classified into three types. One, body centered. Tell me, in body centered, particles are present at corners and center of unit cell. Particles present at corners and center of unit cell. Next, face centered unit cell. Yeah, can you tell me example for this body centered? So example for body centered, tell me. It is a BCC, no? Body centered cubic. Take this example. It is a cube. Corner is, particle present at corner is compulsory. Okay. Along with corner, there is a one particle also present where? Center of unit cell. This is a example for what? Body centered unit cell, that is nothing but cubic crystal, which is called BCC. Example for body centered unit cell. Next, face centered unit cell. Particle present at corners as well as center of each face. Right, it is a cube. Tell me, now where the particle present? Corner is compulsory, right? Yes or no? Yes. Corner is compulsory. Along with corner, okay, along with corner, where the particle present? Center of each face. There are how many faces? Usually cube has six faces, like three opposite. This is a one face, opposite face, left, right, up, down. Total three opposite faces. It means six faces. So here also, let us take, it is a up, down, left, right, back. This is front. So which is called body, face centered unit cell, which is also called FCC. Do you know FCC also called CCP? Okay, cubic close packing. So why it is called CCP? We'll study later in packing efficiency. Okay. So this is example for face centered unit cell. Next is end centered unit cell. Tell me, in case of end centered unit cell, particles are present at corners is compulsory. Along with corner, any two particle present where? Opposite faces. So opposite faces, like, you know, front, you know, front, back, up, down, any two opposite, right, left. Now, for example, if you take front and back, which is called alternate, why these opposite faces are called alternate faces? For example, if the particle present front and back face, So you just imagine there is one particle here, middle, right? On this face. There is a particle in this face, no particle, there is a particle. That is the meaning of alternate, no? Do you remember? Alternate double bonds. What is the meaning of alternate double bond? Single bond, double bond. Single bond, double bond. Right? Benzene has alternate double bonds. Yes or no? So alternate means there is a single, double, single, double. Here also same, it is alternate. One phase particle is there, next phase no particle, particle. Right? So any two opposite, or else you can take here, these two opposite. So there is a particle, no particle, particle. There is a particle, no particle, particle. So any two opposite faces gives alternate faces. That is called alternate arrangement. So therefore, here, definition is the unit cell in which particles are present at corners and any two opposite faces or are alternate faces. Any two faces or alternate faces. Tell me, what is the example? Let us take cube, right? So there is a 8 particles on 8 corners. It is a common, right? Okay, next. Along with corner where the particles should be present. Any two opposite face. You can take either up, down or right, left, front, back. Any two opposite. Okay. It is called end-centered. End-centered cubic crystal. End-centered cubic crystal. Okay. But see, there are 7 type of crystals we study later. Out of 7 type of crystal systems, one of the crystal system is cube. Cube, orthorhombic, tetrahedral, trigonal, monoclinic, triclinic, there are total 7 type of crystal systems. Out of 7 type of crystal system, this is one of the crystal system is cube. In our syllabus, we have only study of cube. Okay, in detail study of only cube is there. That's what, let us study of cube. Write down, a cube contain. A cube contain. I'll draw the cube here. Okay. It is a cube. Can you tell me, a cube contain how many corners? It's a corner, no?
8 corners.
Right? So there are how many total? 8 corners. Next, a cube contain how many faces? 6. This is one face, no? Six faces. A cube contain how many center?
One.
Center is always
one.
One. Right? And a cube contain how many edges?
Two.
How many edges? Edges. Yeah. Edges. Now it is imaginary line which connect to corners. That is one corner, that is another corner. Tell me, in between two corner, one edge. That is one, it is 2, 3, 4. Similarly, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Right? Therefore, edge is an imaginary line which connect two corners. So therefore, now you can take this is one edge. Right? Tell me, there are how many edges? 12 edges. Okay. Next, similarly, a cube contain body diagonal line, face diagonal line. So what is face diagonal line and what is body diagonal line? See, yeah, diagonal line is an imaginary line, an imaginary line which connect two opposite corners. For example, you take this is one face, right? This is one face. Right. On this face, you take that corner and this corner. Tell me, two corners can be, two opposite corners can be connected by imaginary line. Which imaginary line? Diagonal line. Which is called what? Face diagonal line. Now, there is another diagonal line. It is also what? Face. So, each face has two diagonal lines. That is one and this is two. Like that, there are how many faces? Six faces. So, each face has two diagonal line. There are six faces has 12 diagonal lines. Which diagonal line? Face diagonal line. Right? So, therefore, if I want to show here, you can take this is one imaginary line which connect two opposite corners. Okay. So like that, here also one more. Right. It is another. So therefore, so each face has how many? Two, it means total 12 face diagonal lines. Right. So there are 12 face diagonal lines. Now I want how many body diagonal lines? So what is, yeah, what is body diagonal line? Body diagonal line is, it is also imaginary plane which connect the two opposite corner, but it must be passes through the center of the body. Right. Center of the body. For example, you take this corner and that corner. That is one, right? So that means two opposite corner gives one body diagonal line. There are how many opposite corners? How many opposite corners are there?
Four.
Total eight, no? 1, 2, 3, 4, total eight corners. How many opposite?
Four.
That is one. From here to here, two. There to here,
three.
There to here?
Four,
no? It means, so total how many body diagonal lines?
Four.
Because two opposite corners gives one body diagonal line. There are total four opposite corners, four body diagonal line. So therefore, first of all, you should know what is body diagonal line. Body diagonal line is this line. It is an imaginary line which passes through the, where?
Center.
Which passes through the center and which connect the two opposite corners diagonally. So therefore, this diagonal line is called body diagonal line. There are total how many? Four body diagonal lines. So therefore, when you study about cube, so we need to study all points about this. One, corners. How many corners?
Eight.
A cube has always eight corners. Next, two, faces. A cube has how many faces?
Six
faces. Next, a cube has how many centered? Only one center. A cube has how many edges?
12
edges. Right. A cube has how many face diagonal line? 12 face diagonal line. How many body diagonal line?
Four
body diagonal lines. Okay. Next, right. Calculation of number of particles over our effective atoms per unit cell. Calculation of number of particles over our effective atoms per unit cell. So which is usually denoted by Z, in some book given N also. right? So calculation of number of particles or effective atoms or effective particles per unit cell, right? So before going to the calculation, we need to see first if the particle present at corner or face centered or body centered and or edge centered, what is the contribution or what is the contribution of that particle towards particular unit cell. For example, tell me, if the particle present at corners, take one corner particle, okay, if the particle present at corner, this corner particle shared with how many corner particles, how many unit cells?
8
unit cells. How? For example, you just imagine one particle present at corner, that corner, okay. If the particle present at corner, that corner particle shared with total 8 unit cells. How? This is one unit cell, adjacent one, backside another one, backside to that another one, 4 or 1, 2, 3 floor. So in this floor 4, but that corner, you know, there is another floor, innond floor idire aa corner common agutalla. That means that corner is common for total how many, like this, you know, like this rooms, total 8. Okay, so therefore if an atom present at the corner, if the particle present at corner which is shared with total how many, 1 2 3 4 and 4, total 8 adjacent unit cell. Therefore what is the contribution of one particle, what is the contribution of that particle toward this unit cell? Very good, 1/8. It means, what is the meaning of this? For example, you can take here, there is a one corner particle, right? This corner particle is one corner particle, it is total, you know, shared with how many unit cells? It is shared with a total 8 unit cells, like this. Okay, 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8. Therefore this 1/8 part is there, no? This 1/8 part is only belongs to this unit cell. That is the meaning. The remaining part is, the remaining, there are 7 unit cells. Next point B. Okay, if an atom present at the center of each face, you take this face only. If an atom present at the center of the each face or center of the face, this face particle is shared with how many adjacent unit cell? 2, because this is one unit cell. Moreover, this wall is for two rooms, no? Common for two rooms. If the particle present here, that particle belongs to this unit cell. This room. And if there is another room backside, that is also 1. It means 1 1 2. Therefore what is the contribution of this particle towards this unit cell? 1/2. Next C. If an atom present at the center of unit cell, you just imagine in middle there is one particle, that particle is completely belongs to this unit cell. Why? Is it shared with the adjacent unit cell? No. Therefore if the particle or if an atom present at the center of unit cell, so it is do not shared with any other unit cells. Therefore it is completely belongs to this unit cell. Therefore what is the contribution of that particle? 1. Next D. If an atom present at the center of edge, you can take, if atom present here, center of the edge, tell me this edge is common for how many unit cells? This one room adjacent, up 4, there up 4, how many? 4. It means this edge is common for a total 4 like these rooms. Therefore if one particle present at the center of one edge, that is shared with total how many unit cells? Total 4 unit cell. Therefore what is the contribution of each particle towards this unit cell? 1/4. Therefore this contribution you must remember. Okay, what is the contribution of corner particle? 1/8. What is the contribution of face particle? 1/2. Contribution of center particle? 1. Contribution of edge center particle? 1/4. Next, if you remember this contribution, there is a direct formula. So how do you calculate number of particles per unit cell? Number of particles per unit cell equal to, there is a total number of particles into contribution of each particle towards particular unit cell. Okay, so this is the formula to calculate number of particle per unit cell. Okay, so you have taken this, no, right from here onwards. Calculation of number of particles per unit cell or effective atom per unit cell. Right. If an atom present at the corner of unit cell, here say unit cell means what? Cube. We study only cube only. Okay, you need not to think of any other unit cell. It's cube only. Right. If an atom present at the center of, corner of unit cell, which is shared with how many? Eight adjacent unit cells. Therefore, the contribution of each particle towards particular unit cell is how much? 1/8. The contribution of each particle towards particular unit cell is 1/8. Next, if an atom present at center of phase, if an atom present at center of phase, which is shared with how many? Two adjacent unit cells. Therefore, the contribution of each particle towards one unit cell is 1/2. Next point. If an atom present at center of unit cell, shared with only one unit cell, therefore the contribution of that particle towards particular unit cell is how much? 1. Next, if an atom present at center of edge shared with center of edge shared with four adjacent unit cells, shared with four adjacent unit cells. Therefore, the contribution of particle towards one unit cell is the contribution of particle towards one unit cell is 1/4. Okay. So take this tabular column. Right. Here, right, position of particle it is sharing with number of unit cell next contribution towards one unit cell. So position of particle, second column, sharing with number of unit cells, and third one is contribution towards one unit cell. Right, position is 1 corner, 2 face, 3 center of unit cell, and 4 edge. Tell me, corner, face, center of unit cell, and last one is edge center or edge. So sharing with how many unit cell in corner? 8. Here sharing with how many unit cell? Face 2, center 1, edge 4. So what is the contribution towards one unit cell? It is 1/8. It is 1/2, 1/4. So take this form one relation. Number of particle per unit cell equal to number of particles per unit cell equal to total number of particles into contribution of each particle towards particular unit cell. Okay, take calculation of number of particle per unit cell in simple cubic crystal. Tell me, so which is, you know, usually denoted by N or Z also. N equal to, in simple cubic crystal where the particles are present, corners. There are how many corners? 8 into. What is the contribution of each corner particle? 1/8. So therefore, N equal to 1. that is effective number of atom is 1. Next, B. BCC, calculation of number of particles per unit cell, BCC. Tell me, in BCC, where the particle present? Corners and center of unit cell. So corners and center of unit cell, both. Therefore, now tell me, the contribution of corner particle and contribution of center particle, both are same or different? Different. Corner particle contribution is 1 by 8. Center particle contribution is 1. Therefore, there are how many corner particle? 8. 8 into 1 by 8 plus 1 into 1. Right? We should take separately. Not like 8 plus 1, 9. It is a corner particle. This is center particle. Both have different contribution. So, therefore, N equal to 2. Next. FCC. Face-centered cubic crystal, which is also called CCP. Is it FCC equal to HCP? No. FCC is not, is it? Both same? FCC is a face-centered cubic, HCP is hexagonal close packing. Hexagonal is different, cube is different. But in 2012, there was a question given in board exam. Calculate the packing efficiency of HCP. Unfortunately, HCP is not there in syllabus. But they thought that HCP equaled FCC. That was a blunder mistake. Right. Okay. So, therefore, tell me. Okay. Now, tell me where N equal to what? In FCC, particle present at corner, right? Okay, 8 into 1 by 8 plus particle also present at center of each face. There are how many faces? 6. What is the contribution? 1 by 2. Therefore, N equal to, it is 1 plus 3. It becomes 4. Right? So, these three we study in our PU level. But there is one more important example, HCP. Calculation of number of particle per unit cell in hexagonal close packing, HCP. Right, calculation of number of particles per unit cell in hexagonal close packing, which is also called HCP. Okay. See, HCP is completely different from cube. So, where HCP hexagonal, it has hexagonal ring, right? It is like this. There are two hexagonal ring like this. It is one, it is another one, right? Okay, this is hexagonal. It is one ring, another ring. There are two rings. Can you tell me there are how many total corners? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. In one ring, 6. Here also 6. So therefore, there are total how many? 12 corners. right? In HCP, there are 12 particle present at 12 corners. And there are two more particle present in center of each face. This is face. It is also face in two faces. And three particle present in center of unit cell. Like this. There are three particle present center of unit cell. So this is the structure of HCP, hexagonal close packing, right? So therefore, in hexagonal close packing, there are total 12 corner particles, two face particles, three center particles. Okay, right. So center is only one, but particles are three. Irbodalva? One central, three particle. Yaar bedantara? Okay. Then now tell me, what is the number of particle per unit cell? So total how many corner particle? 12. So 12 into, what is the contribution of corner particle? 1 by 6 or 1 by 8? Pratika? 1 by 8. Wrong. So why it is wrong? See, you just imagine, take this is one corner. If you take one corner, there is another unit cell like this. There is another unit cell this side also, no? This is take one unit cell. This is second unit cell. Okay. This is third, no? Possible, no? Okay. For this corner, 1, 2, 3. Another floor? It means this corner is common for total 6 hexagonal rings. Or this one hexagonal ring corner, you know, shared with total 6 hexagonal. 1, 2, 3. And another floor is 3. Right? So therefore, what is the contribution? 1 by 6, but not 1 by 4, 1 by 8. 1 by 8 comes where in? Cube. If it is a cube, 1 by 8. But hexagonal, 1 by 6. That is the difference. Next. Plus, there are two particles on where? Face centered. 2 into. What is the contribution? Face is 1 by 2. If particle present here, and above this hexagonal ring, one more ring will be there. Right? So half for that ring, half for this ring. It means 1 by 2 plus, if the particle present at the center of unit cell, we know that it completely belongs to that unit cell. So therefore, what is the contribution? 3 into 1. So which is equals to 6. Right? That is the hexagonal close packing 6. Okay, take this type of crystal lattice. And effective number of atoms. Effective atoms, nothing but Z or N. Tell me. So type of crystal lattice, one simple cubic crystal, 2 BCC, 3 FCC, 4 HCP, FCC also called CCP. Tell me, so what is the number of particle per unit cell? First one, 1, it is 2, 4, 6. 1, 2, 4, 6. Number of particle per unit cell. Okay.